Hello and welcome to this Forex Preview at XM.com. I'm Maria Pachardis and joining me is investment analyst Marios Hadjikyriakos. We'll be discussing the upcoming U.S. jobless claims report and the market effects. So, Marios, this Thursday, the data coming out in the U.S., the weekly jobless claims, are really important because they'll reveal how much damage the virus outbreak has already had on the U.S. economy. Are we expecting a huge surge in the numbers of Americans filing for unemployment benefits? And what will this mean for stock markets?
We are, Maria. In fact, we are expecting the biggest increase on record. The forecasts suggest that the number of Americans filing for unemployment benefits last week was 1 million, and the previous all-time record was less than 700,000. So, this is pretty significant. Now, if you look at what each individual state has been reporting, I think that we're likely to get a number higher than 1 million, maybe significantly higher than that. So there are a lot of examples, but I'll take my favorite one, Ohio. So Ohio is a state with less than 12 million people. And last week, it reported 140,000 people filing for unemployment benefits just in that 1 week. That was a 28-fold increase from the previous week. So, you know, maybe other states weren't as bad as Ohio, but even if they weren't, you know, even if the situation wasn't as bad in other states, we are still likely to get a number above a million, in my opinion. So what does that mean? It means that Americans are being laid off from their jobs at a very, very quick pace. And that's worrisome because it creates a sort of feedback loop. So fewer people with jobs means that those people are now consuming less. That comes back to businesses through reduced demand for their products, and then those businesses might fire more people, and you have a vicious cycle. That's how crises begin. So I think that we're likely to get a disappointing number this week, and if that happens, that probably scare the stock market. So we've seen stocks rebound this week on the back of hopes for fiscal stimulus, but if we get a very disappointing jobless print on Thursday, we might see those gains evaporate and stocks might even trade lower.
Okay, so what about the dollar? Is it likely to be negatively affected by all this?
Maybe so, but I wouldn't expect any negative reaction to be huge. So the dollar has been gaining recently because, well, the dollar lately has been moving with the risk sentiment, basically. So that when stocks fall and there's panic in the markets, the dollar tends to rise. So I think that's the biggest driver for the dollar right now. And I don't think that the economic data will play a huge role in driving the dollar in the near term, especially now that the Fed has already cut interest rates to 0% and there's no monetary policy divergence to consider. So yes, we might see the dollar take a little bit of a hit if the data are weak, but I wouldn't expect any reaction to be huge. And if stock markets really do sell off on this data, then, you know, we might see the dollar eventually come back in demand.
Marios, thanks so much. And thanks for joining us at XM.com.